the winter. Hello, hello, and welcome to Voice of the Audience. We are building up right now. This is Agnes Pratt, Queen of Social Media. Long lost and found. I'm back again with your favorite program. And that's you, Voices of the Audience. This is Agnes Pratt here, Queen of Social Media. Thank you very, very, very much for joining in. Tonight is all about politics. We'll be talking about politics tonight. I'm going down to West Africa, the Gambia, my sister country. And tonight we'll be talking about the Gambia. And the topic tonight is what next after Jammeh exile. Education, agriculture, economy, all and sundry. Will Gambia be the paradise of no corruption or heaven for all? That is the topic tonight. But before I start, I just want to start with this. It's like a brilliant quote on here, because now and then again I'll be taking some quote from Facebook, and then we start the program with it. Sometimes I'll be using music and that, but today I'm going to start with this quote from Daphne Pratt, Cassandra Kitchen, all the way from United States of America. And right now in Facebook world, say this was Sunday. She wrote this on her Facebook page. It said, "Father God." Let me have it up there so it's easier for me to read. She's saying, "Father God, keep me and deliver me not to be like Hillary Clinton, who sees the seat of president but cannot sit, nor her supporters who are running like mad dogs under the cold butt. For God of Mayor One, let me be like President Trump," that Philip Pratt say, "who see the seat." Okay, "is not fit for the office, but will go down in history as president who has no experience." Let me go again. "Will go down in history as president who has no experience and has a porn star and foreigner as the first lady." And she's laughing, "ki ki ki. Thanks to God, I typed in that amen." Amen. This is brilliant. And this is coming from Daphne Pratt from United States of America, Cassandra Kitchen. Now, today, before we start the Jammeh saga, we have Gina Miller. She is the plaintiff for a Supreme Court ruling today, which we are going to talk on briefly before I go to the next topic. Now, Gina Miller is an unemployed cardinal. She is 51 years of age. So, she is the lead plaintiff in today's Supreme Court ruling against government, parliament to give vote on Brexit. Yeah. Now, the ruling today, apparently, the Supreme Court ruled by majority of 8-3 that the government, that the UK government here, must seek the authorization of parliament before triggering Brexit, which they didn't do. Now, some people might want to know, what article did this woman use as a private bill to Parliament? Well, what Miller used and her group against the Brexit is Article 50 of the Treaty of Lisbon, which gives any EU member the right to quit unilaterally and outline the procedure for doing so. There was this has a lot of political undertones and all that and what have you, but like they are against Britain leaving European Union. So they've used Article 50 of the Treaty of Lisbon, that they can use that treaty to, the United Kingdom can use that treaty to leave or to stay. So there was no way to legally leave the EU before the treaty was signed in 2007. It gives the leaving country 2 years to negotiate an exit deal. Once set in motion, it cannot be stopped except by unanimous consent of all member states. Any deal must be approved by a qualified majority of EU member states and can be voted by the European Parliament. In November 2016, the High Court ruled that the government cannot trigger Article 50 without MPs voting on the matter. First, the Supreme Court upheld the ruling in January 2017. That was today, earlier today. Now, the ruling will mean that government has just over 2 months to push the legislation through both the Commons and the Lords to meet Mrs. May's deadline of triggering Article 50 by the end of March. Jeremy Corbyn, the Labour leader, is expected to attempt to amend the bill in a bid to force Theresa May to send the terms of a final deal back to Brussels if Parliament votes against it. So that is briefly whatever that is the saga that is going on right now. You know, Brexit, not Brexit. Yeah, Jama don't go exile, so yeah. Now let's come to the topic for tonight. Yes. President Yahya Jammeh, okay, in the first place, as a journalist, I do not support President Yahya Jammeh being in power for 22 years, which is like 2 decades plus. Over like 2 decades, over 2 decades. It should have given other people the opportunity to, you know, contest, just like how he was, and President Yahya Jammeh should have also. 1 minute, guys, my land phone is, this is social media, right? Okay, I'm back, sorry for that. So yeah, I'm not in support of President Yahya Jammeh to be in power for over 2 decades now. I'm not in support of that. I would have loved for him to have like left willingly, not like the way how he left his own country that he has worked so hard for. Nevertheless, yes, some school of thought might say it's undemocratic. Some school of thought might say, well, come on. We have the Queen of England as a queen for over how many decades now and blah, 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 and that. So is that democratic or undemocratic? We have the Queen of Holland is there as well. We have President Mugabe is in his country as well for over how many decades now. And so is that on them? Everybody have their own thing actually, but that's not the point why I'm here for tonight. Why I'm here for tonight is for us to take a sit back and look at what this means for the people of the Gambia and what this means for us, especially in West Africa. Now, did I ever tell you that Yahya Jammeh, yes, have a peace foundation? Yes, Yahya Jammeh have a peace foundation, and his peace foundation was established 25th of May 2001, a joint project with the Gambian Department of State for Health at Bondom. I don't know, some of you from Gambia, you might correct me, but the spelling is Bondom. Bondom is the most densely populated area in the Gambia. So what Yahya Jammeh did, what, you know, like when we, like for me, I'm from Sierra Leone, like Kutan Bay, where we have so many poor people living in there. And then, for example, now President Kumar will go and establish this big health center there, where even people who are living in the most upper high scales of living areas in Sierra Leone, they'll come there for treatment. So this is what Yahya Jammeh did. He ensured that where his people will be having free medical treatment, including people who have money to look after themselves of the, or their health, he ensured that he established this health center or this hospital in Bondom, the most densely populated area of the Gambia. Now, we have so many people, over 1,000 or so people who have benefited from that project. You know, like for example, the Obamacare project, like in America, health insurance is very, very, very expensive. And when the Obamacare came into place, it helped so many poor families in America. It's something like that I can compare and contrast to what Yahya Jammeh did in the Gambia. Yahya Jammeh came with the Yahya Jammeh Peace Foundation, wherein he ensured that people who are poor, who cannot afford to they you know. So but let me just go now to the next, to my next, oh God, sorry guys, my land phone again. This is not good. Okay. All right. So, like I was saying, so this is what Yahya Jammeh did. And then if we go down to agriculture, we all know the cash crop in the Gambia is granite. Yeah, granite. Granite is a cash crop. 80% of Gambians, they depend on agriculture. Because remember, their country is more of tourism and agriculture. So what Yahya Jammeh did also to empower farmers, he ensured that he invested into agriculture in the Gambia. Yeah, if I have some other documents which I am going to take out there and read to you. Yeah, but I'll come to that later. Now I'm under agriculture, and he ensured that most people owns farm in the Gambia, that and they don't depend on goods that are being exported into their country. They depend on their own food. That's why you see Gambians are so healthy. Health-wise, they have good food. They're so healthy. Yeah? This is what Yahya Jammeh did under his government. Now, let's come under economy. Under the economy, when Yahya Jammeh was in power as president of the Gambia, you know, he makes sure he has an open type of economy. We are in export or import is open to everybody. But watch what he did. One good thing he did, oversee investment areas of Yahya Jammeh, like people who are coming from the West, where Yahya Jammeh was mostly concerned, where they should invest. Let me go to these areas so that you will see. And then at the end of this program, you can now decide to still see Yahya Jammeh as this horrible president in the world, or somebody who cares for his people despite being in power for over 22 years. Now, if you are to go and invest in the Gambia, whatever it is, yeah, what Yahya Jammeh did, he encouraged foreign investment mainly on agriculture, especially horticulture, and also floriculture, and then animal husbandry, yes, fruit, vegetable processing, and canning. These are the areas that Yahya Jammeh, you know, ensure that anybody coming into the Gambia to invest, these are the areas that he was willing for people, for investors to invest. And we all know somebody go and do like 20 acres of land, you are going to create employment for the citizen of that country. So in so doing, Yahya Jammeh, oh God, sorry guys, my mobile phone again, my phone. Oh, I'm having external call, but anyway, let me just leave it. Let me just mute it. 1 minute, guys. Social media, sorry. Okay, like as I was saying, this is what Yahya Jammeh did. So when you go to Gambia, if you want to go and invest, he ensures that you will have to employ the local people there, and by that you are creating employment for his people. That's what he did. Now let's go to education of the child. When Yahya Jammeh was there, let's go back from 1998 to the period of 2003. We all know the Gambia, when it comes to the child education, we are not so keen on the child education by then. But what happened is that when Yahya Jammeh came to power, yeah, he ensured that the girl child education was taken into consideration and it was number one on his agenda, his action plan. Before long, we'll know, Gambia woman and need to go to school or blah, 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 doing our mom days. But now, Gambia women are the most educated around Africa. And who powered that? Who prompted that? Yahya Jammeh prompted that. Yeah? And today we have 50% of Gambian women in high places, not only within the Gambia, but when you go to United Nations and these other international organizations, you see Gambian women. Not that Gambian woman where you just a towel of my just a tie la pie tie the cook and blah blah blah. Don't matter cow man. No, they are highly educated women now. Before long ago, they go to Gambian woman then I elite kids. No. Now they are the most educated within West Africa. So these are the good side of Yahya Jammeh. I'm just bringing it out to you. And because in Africa, as we all know, especially like from Sierra Leone, but the Gambia more, that is the Muslim populated area. Because of the Muslim tradition, girls are supposed to be at home and then men are supposed to go out. But Yahya Jammeh, in as much as people despise him, in as much as people are saying he is a human rights violator, he ensures that education for the girl child was his priority. And when he was in power, guess what again? Who was his vice president? His vice president was Aissatou Ndiaye, a woman. A woman was his vice president. Let's go to Ghana, Nigeria, Sierra Leone, Senegal. When did we ever have a woman vice president? Would that even happen? Would that ever happen? I don't think so. But Yahya Jammeh, yeah, and sure, his vice president was a woman. Despite the bigger media corporation try to sell him out as this big demonic president Africa have ever got. But now, remember that as well. That's good side. Now, if you go to any country, tax is very important. It's only of late, like my country, Sierra Leone, they are doing tax or they are into tax now, yeah? Now, let me take you back to the Gambia. In the Gambia, gain or profit, they pay tax. The areas they pay tax, income from any trade, business, profession, or vacation. Tourists, them when they go Gambia, they pay tax. If you're not teacher, they pay tax. Anybody, they pay tax. You know, Yahya Jammeh single-handedly with his government put that in place. Yeah? And also, it ensure that Gambians, majority of the business holders are Gambians. I'm from Sierra Leone, West Africa, should I want to go and establish any business in Gambia, I need a Gambian to be my number one. Do we do that in Sierra Leone? In Ghana? I'm not too sure. So these are some of the qualities of President Yahya Jammeh. Now, I would like to take us back to, you know, I'm very, very, very much a political thinker. I think out of the box, you know. I look on leaders that people criticize so bad, especially the West. And I look at things that other people are turning their eyes off from. Things, qualities that they have. So with me, I'm not again supporting Yahya Jammeh to be in power for over 22 years now, but let's take into consideration what he has done for that country. Let's go back to Libya. Libya, under the leadership of Gaddafi, they have free medication. It was the best place to live. Libya is an African country, yeah? But Libya, their facility they have is more than me and you living in the UK here when President Gaddafi was in power. But after President Gaddafi was killed, he said he's a dictator. Go back again. Is Libya in the news? Now, all of the international corporations, they are the one running Libya right now. All of the multinationals, the millionaires, trillionaires, they are the one running Libya. They are the one supplying goods. They are the one building bridges. They are the one, you name it. All of the projects there. And some area, you know, they are deadbeats right now. Nothing is active in Libya in some areas. So this Adama Barrow or Will Barrow or what is it? For me, I personally just don't like him because he is going to be a puppet leader. I can tell you this. What would you imagine from a man from being in Agos or being a salesman or whatever to politics? Does he know what politicking is all about? For me, he is just an accidental hero. He is going to feast on the hard work of Yahya Jammeh and his government. That is my own side on this. And everybody have right to their own opinion. So, because I've compared and contrast the knowledge that Yahya Jammeh have and do in running a country, and that is a vast difference. Barrow will be that president that will have all of these people come into Gambia and destroy Gambia. The economy is going down. You mark this right now. The economy is going to be zero. Tourism is going to be zero. Nothing good is going to come off the Gambia. Because he does not have that charisma of a good leader. Like Yahya Jammeh, who will stood up to people that you cannot come and tell me what is good for my family. I know what is good for my family. If we are here in the West, tell me how many times in even our places of work, the disadvantages that happens, the things that happens to us in our places of work, for example, even the UK here, who says human rights violations are not happening? They are happening every other day. It's only some people who are persistent to fight for themselves, to stand up for themselves. They will cause so much noise with that. And then they will say, okay, she knows what she's doing. He knows what he's doing. How many of our young black boys who haven't done anything, but because they are looking to close cases, they are being dragged into it. And some of them, they are serving jail terms that they don't even have the right to be there. Will you now tell me that after Yahya Jammeh is being exiled to Equatorial Guinea, the Gambia is going to be a paradise? Will you now tell me that after Yahya Jammeh is being exiled to Equatorial Guinea, the Gambia is going to be the best tourist attraction in the world? No, because anybody that comes into your country is to come and suck up and go and build their country. This is why Africa, we are so lacking. This is why Africa, when it comes to being independent, when it comes for us to take over our fears, it's not now, it's not the year after, because we rely so much on other people's handouts and other people, whatever big talk show they are doing. Africans, you people need to think out of the box. You people need to read between the lines. You people need to stay there and say, okay, fear enough. Yeah, Jamen, haven't got no business to stay in power for over 22 years. But is Barrow or Will Barrow the right candidate, the right presidency to lead the people of Gambia? Is he the right one? What knowledge have you got in governance? What knowledge have you got? The man has spent his life, all of his life here. All of his life here. He just walked in there and is sitting out there with two wives, feasting upon what other people have worked on. Africans, wise up. Wise up. You have to wise up. Because if you do not take your own affairs, if you do not take your country seriously, if you do not take the responsibility to run your own affairs, it's just like when you allow people to push it here and there and there and there. They can do whatever they want to do to you. Because you know why? You are a seat filler. A seat filler. And it's high time, if we are so bold to be denouncing President Trump, yeah? This is, you see, Africans, we are so hypocrites. We two hypocrite Africans. Black people, I don't know what is wrong with your way of thinking, or I don't understand. I don't know your political school of thought. I don't know. You always sit there, you allow people to think for you, eat for you, everything for you, put everything in the plate, because black people don't want to think for themselves. They don't want to take their own affairs and run their own affairs themselves. We like the easy ride. But with Yahya Jammeh, you not have easy ride with him. You have to work. You have to work. So if people are of the view that yes, President Yahya Jammeh is no longer there, oh yes, they are jubilating out in the street and so, I'm giving you just 6 months. 6 months I'm giving you, Gambians. If you're not careful, your country is going to go down just like the Libyans. If you're not careful. Because having to go and have Will Barrow as your president, for me, there's nothing about him that give me that impression that he is a leader. There's nothing. He's like a puppet. When they say shoot, he run. That, you know, this is what's going to happen, and that's the reality. People might say whatever they want to say. Oh, Agnes, you don't know the Gambia, blah blah blah, this or that, or blah blah blah, this. Yes, I feel your frustration, but start to think out of the box. What would this mean for your agriculture, for your education? The Gambia 2016, is it going to degenerate into being nothing, or is it going to be upgraded to where Jammeh have left it? Yeah? Well, that's my own piece. Because anything that affects Gambia affects Sierra Leone. And I can count myself a Gambian. Because half of our people, they are in Gambia. So, it's our responsibility to really look not about personalizing. Oh, yeah, yeah, Jamie been killed me, uncle, this or that. Okay, we're sorry you lost your families and blah, blah, blah. Yes? Even here, don't we have innocent people that they kill on the road? They shoot and kill. Even here, as I'm speaking to you, we have it all over the world. Even America, they say blah, blah, blah. So we've seen every day they're killing people there, especially black people. So why didn't you rise up against that? No. Well, it was easy to rise up against President Yahya Jammeh. It's wrong for him to be in power for over 20 years. It is wrong categorically. I'm not supporting it. But take into consideration this. If you Gambians are not careful, your country is going to be worse off where Jammeh is living. Where Jammeh has left it now is going to be worse off. This video is going to be uploaded up on my YouTube page. So for years to come, you go back and revisit this video, and then that's how it goes. You know, President Trump is there in America. All what he has said, all what he is, yeah, he is there as president. He is there, yeah, one of the worst human rights violators of the world. He is very disrespectful towards women. Yes, did he choose his vice president to be a woman? No. Before I leave again, I noticed something, and I can't keep my mouth shut on this. During this intervention of Yahya Jammeh and this and that, what I was looking for, my president, your president, our president, Ernest Bai Koroma, was part of the delegation with President John C. Iesiele from Liberia that went over to the Gambia, the first ever meeting they held there. But in all of the conversations, in all of the interviews also, Sierra Leone has not been mentioned, or the role of the president has not been mentioned, because all of the videos I watch on, you see, GRTS and so, a gentleman from United States of America was speaking about this Jammeh saga, blah, blah, blah. But I didn't have anything mentioned about the role of Sierra Leone. I don't know if we are just seat fillers, which I hate to say, or which I hate to think, that we are just seat fillers. We just go into this international whatever it is, meetings, just to add the count, including Sierra Leone. But what was our voice? What does our voice stand for? Anyway, till I see you next Tuesday. Remember, especially to my brothers and sisters from the Gambia, this is time not to jubilate against President Yahya Jammeh, but to embrace the good things he's done in that country and ensure wheelbarrow that has come now to continue what he has done and to make it more better. That what wheelbarrow should do. And in that light, I just want to wish the new government a safe and brilliant stay in power. We hope when they are coming, they don't come to revenge for can't tiff na Gambia. Go and stilo stilo, you know, you go and stilo stilo because for over years and that and that 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 Yahya Jammeh, because the party they cannot power down a new one, not so the old party they've been doing. So the new, you remember SLPP APC. When SLPP left APC car, you see how many mansions and then they build and return all over. So it's just like a vicious circle in Africa. This how the politicians roll. This how things happen. It's just so sad that It asked the citizen that suffered the casualty of no life, no good education. Then they kidnapped journalists, then killed S.O. Williams. General S.O. Williams, a veteran military man. We don't serve now the war. He fights so hard for bring, for restore democracy in the country. He's been killed. And up to now, it's just one big full statement and don't come out. There is no, like, inquest. When somebody like that die in your country, President Koroma, you are living now. You don't know what befalls you after you left office. You don't know. Because people around you right now, they are like doing this thing, this inspiration around you because they want what they want. But you don't know what befalls you, President Koroma, after your tenure of office is finished. Therefore, when we have a president like Yahya Jammeh going into exile, was there any official statement from Sierra Leone? I don't think so. From ECOWAS. S.O. Williams, the government of Sierra Leone should be ashamed of themselves for not having an inquest into the death of a whole veteran, military general who fought so hard to restore democracy and freedom Sierra Leone. We demand an inquest, a national public inquiry into the death of General S.O. Williams, land that we love our country, Sierra Leone. Till I see una anytime soon. Stay blessed and let's continue to pray for the people of Gambia that all of them that takes up office are going to execute their duty at the uttermost best and in favor of the Gambian people.